came from Italy in 1981 as a flute player. It didn't work, so I became a repairman. I found this great repairman, saxophone repairman, that was decided to teach me. And it became my profession, and I love it. And that provided all the rest for me.
He had a kind of strange talent for working on people's instruments, but like beyond that, like listening to their needs, and it's made him pretty much world famous as the premier saxophone repairman. You know, not only be successful at that, but give something back to the community in the form of Michiko Studios, a place where people of all ages, kids on up to famous jazz legends, can come and rehearse.
You know, we are really in Times Square. We are on 46th Street, you know, like 100 feet from Times Square. So we are really in the center of the Broadway community.
Actors come here to work and perfect for auditions, for everything to contribute to the artistic aspect of New York City.
In this neighborhood used to just be full of these old music, either manufacturers, retail stores. All those places are being taken down. You know, people are coming in and buying up the spaces and building hotels. But what was once, you know, a very, very important enclave and shelter for musicians to get work done on their instruments or get new instruments to inspire young kids, the next generation, to, you know, pick up a horn for the first time, is kind of getting wiped out and obliterated.
If we are gone, I don't know what they will do. It's going to affect a lot of people. You know, tourists that are working here, they got a lot of students. You know, it's kind of a, it's larger than a business. You know, there's really around, a lot of people around it.
You know, music is one of the most important things that we have in life. And this is a place where people come to share that, to learn about it, and to pass it on to the next generation.
And Roberto provides that for us, for all of us. And I am deeply indebted to him.